Hello guys, welcome to Amina Automation Labs. Guys, today I'm going to cover that the pending cucumber sessions. So in the previous session of the cucumber, we have seen that okay, how to use data tables, right? This particular session we have covered that how to use data tables in cucumber and everything, and how to use the parameterized test cases in feature file and everything. And then a couple of things we did that how to write the scenario outlined with the different set of data and everything, and how to define the parameterized thing in your in the form of data table objects, okay, in feature file as well as in step definition file. Now if you see the previous code that we have seen, we created one feature file, and let's say I want to use a username password like this, like pipe separated, and I want to create a deal, okay, some form I want to submit with a different set of data, so I can pass the value like this. But the problem here is, if you write like this, and let's see, the step definition file is like this, that I'm creating the screen credentials and of the data table, I'm getting this particular data into this data list, and I'm using data.get0.get0 for first value and for second value like this. Similarly, for if you see that for creating the deal, 0, 1, 2, 3, okay, four values I'm getting with the help of data table, okay, in the form of list object. But if you see the feature file, it is not very much readable format. First of all, that okay, if you submit this particular feature file to any business stakeholder or any product manager or any manual tester, they won't be able to understand okay what kind of data it is. Like test deal, what is test deal? It is a name or what? Thousand is what? What kind of value it is? Okay, it is commission or what exactly it is? Okay, so header we are not passing over here. Column names we are not passing if you are using list object. Okay. So there is another way also to make it more approachable, understanding point of view and readable format point of view. If you want to write, parameterize your test cases with different set of data, easily you can do that. And let's see, I want to create 10 different deals or 5 different deals. So you can pass, okay, set of different data over here, and the same method will be executed, let's see, 5 times or 10 times. So how to do that? And you can provide some headers also or column names also. So how to do that? So let's see, we'll create the similar kind of example, and I'll do one thing, that I'll create a new feature file. Let's see, my feature file name is feature map, or let's see, not feature map, sorry, deals map. Okay, deals map dot feature, right? Deals map dot feature. And what I'll do, I'll simple copy this entire thing from here, I'll paste it over here, so that no need to write the similar kind of things again and again. Now what you have to do, guys, so I know that my username and password will remain same, I just need to pass the column name over here, right? So how to provide the column name? Simple, I'll write like this, again the pipe separated, I know that this is my username, right? And again pipe separated, and this is my password, okay, and pipe separated. So this is done. Now for, I want to create another set of data for deals also. Let's see, I want to create number of deals. Let's say I want to create 2 deals or maybe 3 deals, okay. Test deal 1, test deal 2, test deal 3, and some other value I want to provide. Let's see, 1000, and this is 2000, this is 3000, and let's see, 50, 60 and 70 and 10, 20 and 30. So if you see that free CRM dot application where we were creating this particular deal, I'll show you. So if you see that freecrm.com, I'll log in into this application first. Naveen K, and I think test at the rate 123, and after that, what exactly? I'll be going to this new deal page, and here I'm passing title, company, probability, amount, probability, and commission. These 4-5 values I'm passing over here. Deal name, test deal 1. This is a title. Okay, 1000, 50, and 10. 1000 is maybe amount, 50 is the probability, and commission is 10. Like this. Similarly, I want to create another deal, test deal 2, 2000, 60, 20. Test deal 3, 3000, 70, 30. And I'll provide the header also. Let's see, this is the title. So I'll write, let's see, title. Okay, pipe separated. After that title we have amount, again pipe separated. After that we have probability, pipe separated, and one more thing is there, commission. Okay, commission is there. Now this is a something I can write. You can press Control Shift F to do the proper formatting, like that you can define like this. Okay guys, now so this is, if you want to, let's see, I want to create like this some. Okay, this is the deal amount. Okay, this is the amount. Some formatting you can do, it's up to you, or let it be like this only. Okay, I think that will be like this. So this is title, amount, probability, and commission I am passing over here, and then finally I'm closing the browser. So this is a typical scenario feature file I have written. Okay, now I'll go to my deals step definition. So what I'll do, I'll create another file so that we will not disturb the previous code. And let's see, deal step with map definition. Okay, so the previous example that we covered, that is with list object. Now today I'm going to create with map object. And what I'll do inside my runner class also, I'll deals feature dot feature, instead of this I'll write deals map dot feature. Okay, and then I'll save it. And what I'll do, so there are no step definitions, so I'll copy all the step definition from here and I'll make some changes over here because entire code will remain same. Just copy this and paste it over here. Now what I have to do, and now I'll map one by one. So first step is user is already on login page and title of login page is free CRM. So these two step definition file, I don't need to change anything over here. These two step definitions, everything is perfect. Then user enters username and password. So earlier we were using list object. Now we have to use, guys, map object. So how to use map? So for list object, if you remember that we were using data table credentials and we were converting credentials.raw, which is returning one list of list object. Now, instead of list object, what I have to do, instead of this credentials.raw, I have to use, guys, I have to use one thing, credentials dot, okay, as maps. You have to use credential dot as maps. And we know that, okay, we have stored the value in the form of key and value pair format, because in map always we store the value in the form of key and value pair format. So this is your key, username is key, value is Naveen K, password is key, value is test at the rate 123. Key and value, same thing. Title is the key and this is the value. Amount is the key, this is the value. So what I have to do, we have to pass what kind of key type you are using. So I am using string type, so we have to pass string. Okay, dot class, and value type also we have to pass, guys, string dot class. Okay, dot class, just save it. And credential dot as maps, if you move, it will return one. Okay guys, it will return what? It will return one map object. Okay, credential, it will return map object. So instead of this list, what I have to do, let me change this entire thing. We have to store inside the map object. Okay, so simple, I'll be using map is the interface. Okay, what kind of map it is? It is map of a string of a string type, right? A string comma string, and I'll give some name. Let's see, data is the object reference name, and this map is available in java.util package, so just import it from there. And what exactly it is saying, add, just a minute, credential dot as maps, credential dot as maps, map of a string, just a minute, and that is the data table type. What is the error it's saying? add cast to map string to string. Okay, let's cast it. Okay, yeah, a string of a string type. Okay, so this is what I have written like this. Now what I have to do, guys, okay, so what you have to do, guys, here you have to be a little careful here. So while using the map, so you never know that, okay, sometimes it may be two username, two password. So currently I'm using only, let's see, one username, one password. So we have to follow the standard process. That what exactly you have to do, guys, simple, what you have to do, I'm writing a for loop over here because I'm going to parameterize my test cases. If you remember that, just like in Excel file, we were having number of username and number of password and number of rows and columns. So we have to parameterize it. So whenever we have to use parameterization, in that case, we have to use for loop. That's the biggest advantage with map. Okay, so simple, what I have written over here, I have created one map object, credentials dot as maps object I'm using, string dot class, comma, string dot class. Okay, this as map object will return one list of map. So I'm simply storing inside the map object like this. And that's it. Simple, what you have to do, driver.findElement, by.name, username, dot send keys, data.get. What is your column name? My column name is this. This is my column name, username. And for password, what is the column name? Password. Simple. Okay, so it will pick the value from there, from your feature file. What is a username column value? What is a password column value? And it will write it over here. That's it. This is a for loop you have to use every time if you want to do parameterization. Now the same thing we will do it for this particular thing, for deals information. So for deal, we are passing, see, here is a perfect example. For deal, we are passing three different set of data, right? So what we have to do, I'll remove this list completely that we used earlier. I'll simply using this particular for loop. Okay. And in this particular for loop, what I'm going to do, again, this is a, let's see, deal data is the object name, deal data as map, class of a string class. Okay, again, this is a data. And what exactly you want to pass? Just a minute, I'll do one thing. Let me take that XPath also. So let's do it over here. Right. Sorry. Don't worry, I'll explain again. It's very, very simple, guys. You just need to be careful while writing the code. I'll take this for loop so that, okay, I'll put it over here. Right. And this is a deal data, string of a string class, right? And I have to enter the values now, okay? Where exactly I have to enter the value? I have to enter the value over here in title, in amount, probability, and commission. So how to enter? Simple. These are the values are available with the XPath, right? And let me delete all these things so that, right. Now in the map, what is my data object? This is my data object, data dot, instead of, now we don't need get zero or the all these hard-coded values, data dot, okay, get, what is the key? Key is, what is the key? This is the key. The first is title. Okay, I'll take this T. Key is title, amount, title, then data dot get key, right? What is the second value? Title and then amount. Okay, make sure that don't do any copy mistake, okay, copy paste mistake or any, okay, spelling mistake. Exact column name, guys, you have to use data dot get. And for fourth value also, I'll using data dot get. And what is the value of third and fourth value? Probability and commission. The exact column name that you have using over here, same column name, you have to use it over here. And the last one is the commission. So that's why I always copy paste like this from for the column values. Okay, commission. Now you see I'm using data table concept again, but in the form of map object. So initially we were using in the previous session with the help of list object. So inside the list object, that is the disadvantage, that this is a list object example, that we cannot parameterize our test cases. First of all, I mean, with the number of set of data, if you have only one record, okay, or one set of data, then only we can use that. Okay. And if you really want to use the map object, that's the biggest advantage, that we can define the different set of data. The thousand of set of data we can define immediately after this particular step, with the column names also, with the headers also we can define. So it is now more readable format, more behavioral readable format. That's why this is called behavioral driven development framework, right? So anyone can use that. Okay, yes, please. Then user enters deal details, and these are the columns that we are going to put. Okay, and these are the values we are going to fill. Okay, we are going to enter, okay, on the page. Now, simple. So that's the biggest advantage. You can write the for loop over here, and you can parameterize your test cases with a different set of data, right? Now, if you run this program, now let's run it, and now everything is fine. All other things will remain same, that this particular step, all these steps will remain same. Now, what I'll do, I'll go to my runner class. I'll start with dry run. I'll check any step definition is missing or not. The mapping is proper or not. Simple, run it. Okay. So I'll run it. And I'll check everything is fine. Everything is mapped. Okay, there is no step definition is missing. Okay, all these concepts I have already covered, guys. So now what I'll do, simple runner class, and I'll make it false. Okay, now I'll make it in a proper way. Okay, with dry run equal to, without dry run, I'll run it with dry run equal to false. Now if you run it, let's run it and we'll see it is running or not. Yes, it is running. So it's launching the browser. It will enter the username password from the map value. Yes, it is entering. And let's see, is it creating three deals or not? Let's see. Okay, see first. Oh, that's a problem, right? So did you observe one thing? What's the problem? The problem here is that this particular test case is parameterized. Okay, the first time deal one, title two, title three. Okay, like this will be created. The first test deal one will be entered, and immediately after that test deal two, okay, will be entered. So what I'm going to do over here, that one thing we have missed, what I'll do, see, I'm entering like this. Let's see, test one. Okay, and then I have to click on save button also. Okay, so let's see, after clicking on save button, it is coming over here. Okay, it will be created. Then again I have to go to deals new deal page, right? And again I have to enter the second value. So how to do that? Simple, first value is entered, and then I have to click on save button also. So let me check for a save button. Do we have any XPath or just a minute? Okay, in the previous class. Okay. Okay, let's create a save button step over here also. Driver dot find element, right? And let me check the XPath of save. Right click, inspect. Save button is input type equal to submit and class equal to button, right? So there is no ID, nothing. So we will be using, okay, XPath. So driver dot find element by dot XPath, and this is input. Okay, so I'll be using customize XPath input like this. Contains what? It contains what type? Okay, at the rate type equal to submit. S is small, right? Yes, S is small, and class is equal to button. So let's see, I'll check with this and dot click. I'm using only one property, type equal to submit, and value is equal to save. Better we use value equal to save instead of submit. At the rate value is equal to save, that will be the proper XPath. Let's see, right? And we can check this particular XPath in Google Chrome, that is a valid XPath or not. So let's see, command F. Okay, see, value U is missing. Value is equal to save, which is, value is equal to save as capital, guys. Okay, still it is not showing. Input contains at the rate value is equal to save, we have to provide the comma. So still with value equal to save, there are four values are there, four, you know, elements are available. So we have to use one more parameter over here, which contains at the rate value is equal to this, and at the rate we'll see, okay, type is equal to submit. Let's see, type is equal to submit. Okay, still it is not showing. Okay, we have to use comma, type comma submit. Okay, let's see, better we remove this contains at the rate value is equal to this, and at the rate type is equal to submit. Still three buttons are available, I mean three buttons is available. Let's see, okay, so let's use this particular XPath. I think this is a correct XPath. Value equal to save and at the rate type equal to submit. So I have already copied this particular XPath over here, type equal to submit and value is equal to save. Okay, and after that I'll click on save button. So once the first deal is created, what I'll do, once I'll go to new deal page, once the first deal is created, let's see, okay, like this, and amount is this, probability is this, and commission is this, I'll have to click on this save button. Again, I have to go to where? I have to go to deals and new deal page, right? Once the first deal is created. So again, I have to write this particular code, go to move to deals and click on new deal page, new deal link. So this code is already written over here, right? For where it is, here it is. I'll create the action class object. Just copy this from here and simple paste it over here, right? So let's see, this is for move to new deal page, right? And this is saving, click on save button, and this is a, and inside the loop I have to do everything because everything is parameterized. Okay, now let's see it is working or not. Let's run this particular thing again in the runner class. Let's run it again. Okay, so see, it is launching the browser, it will enter username and password, correct? Fine. Going to new deals page, okay, and see test deal 1 save, again test deal 2 save, test deal 3 save, and test deal 4 and close the browser. So all the deals got created properly, and if you see all the results for all the steps, everything is perfect now, right? And if you see, let's see if deals got created or not. Let's see, I'll go see all the deals got created over here, right? I think on page number 2, see deal 1, 2, and 3, three deals late, okay, recently I created, okay, all the three deals got created with the proper value, right? Like this. And if you open any particular deal, it's saying that okay, whatever the commission probability we have entered, it's showing like that. So this is a parameterization of the test cases we can achieve, and it's very, very powerful technique, guys, for parameterization with the help of Cucumber. And they will ask you at a time of interview, how can you parameterize your test cases? Okay, you have to use maps, okay, maps in data table. So this is the concept with data tables with maps, okay guys. So always remember, I'll write it over here for you guys, data table with maps for parameterization point of view, parameterization of test cases. Okay, this is a parameterization of test cases, guys. And for this particular session, that's it. Very, very simple concept, guys. You just need to use as maps object, and this little bit changes in the data map, deals map dot feature file, instead of you know, without any headers, you have to use proper header name, or maybe column name you can use, and different set of data also you can provide. And it's okay if you have, let's see, for username and password, we have only one set of data, because generally we don't test with multiple username, multiple password. So you can write like that also, but always provide the column names. That's the biggest advantage. In data table with list object, that's a disadvantage, that you can pass only one parameter. only one set of parameter you can pass without any headers. So it is not very much readable format. Okay, so that's the biggest advantage with maps object. So you can practice and let me know if you have any issues. And I'll check in the code into my Git repositories also. Let's do it right away. So what I'll do, so where is my project? Okay, this is my project, free CRM BDD framework. I'll go to the project location and I'll go to the resources. This is the project location over here. I'll go to my terminal, right? And simple, what I'll do, I'll go to that particular directory, right? And simple, first I'll check the status, git status, right? So today we created these feature file, this particular feature file, this is step definition file we created, right? So let's add all the files, git add space dot, again check the status, everything is green, it's ready to commit. Okay, commit minus m, and let's see, added maps feature, okay, using data table. Okay, and then simple push the code, git push origin master, so it should push, and then I'll enter my password over here for my git repository, and I think it's 100% done. Yes, and then I'll check my repository over here. Let's see, github.com. Okay, sometimes Git is very slow, guys. So yeah, so I'll go to my repository, Cucumber Selenium framework over here, and you can see just 30 seconds ago I have added maps feature using data table. So you can see that. Okay, and one more thing that we haven't seen, right click on it and refresh it. Let's see how exactly the output is coming. index.html file, so go to properties, inside the test output folder index.html file is there. Copy this particular location and let's see how exactly the report is coming. Okay, cool, the report is coming, see, like this. The username password is this, and this is the title. Okay, all the columns values we are getting, okay, and all the values, that three rows we have provided. This is a very good report, and if you share the report with anyone, easily I can understand, okay, what exactly is happening, and everything is green color. It means everything is working fine. Let's see, tomorrow this particular step is getting failed, so immediately this particular line will be marked as red color. So that's the biggest advantage with maps, and you know, if you are using these kind of things, these kind of features with Cucumber, easily you can, okay, define very good BDD framework, okay, and easily anyone can understand these kind of things properly. Okay, so that's all for this particular session, guys. Let me know if you have any issues, and please watch this entire series. Don't jump into Cucumber directly. This is the full series, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll be uploading this particular part 5 also very soon. I mean, immediately after this particular session. So 5 sessions are there. I think 2 more sessions are will be there in Cucumber. One is for tagging, another one is for, we can see it for page object modeling Cucumber. Okay, please subscribe to the channel, guys. There are a lot of things are coming. I'm back to town now, and then a lot of things I'll be uploading over here. Okay, so let me know if you have any issues. This is the channel name, Naveen Automation Labs. You just need to click on subscribe button. That's it. Okay, let me know if you have any issues. Thank you so much, and thanks for watching, guys.